because what we want to know that out of Zion, rule thou. Look what God said. When you know you're protected, you know you're getting your knowledge base from the Lord Jesus Christ. Now what does he tell us? Rule thou in the midst of thine enemies. What's your problem? What's our problem, huh? We got everything we'll ever need to do what God wants us to do if we just do it. We're protected, church. But we must live that way. Psalm 103, we're back ready. We're going to finish this thing out in Psalm 119. It's so much there. Once I finish that, we'll be ready to go, and I'll do it as rapidly as possible. But I want you to focus in on these things. Psalm 103 is a very familiar psalm. It's a psalm of David again. But here's something you should be about, because you're rejoicing in the fact I'm protected. This is why you can say, bless the Lord, oh my soul. And all that is within me. I don't care. I mean, I want you to do bless his holy name.
Yes, sir.
I respect God. I got to bless him because I know where he brought me from. Here again, I'm going to say, bless the Lord, oh my soul. And forget not all his benefits. Why? Because I'm protected. I have the blood of Jesus to cover the multitude of my sins.
Yes,
and even when I mess up, he promised me that if I confess it,
yes,
he's faithful and just to forgive me. And all those that don't know him that well, he said, don't let no so-called folks in the church make you got to think you got to jump and turn cartwheel. He said, whosoever will call upon the name of the Lord,
yes, Lord,
shall be saved. It didn't say that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son to whosoever speak in tongues. Not all that junk. Kick it out.
Yes, Lord, please.
Just simply believe what your father said. Listen. Forget not all his benefits. First time the devil bark at you, everybody get all scared and forget everything God done told you. First time a little something come up in your life. Hey, we can do people. But we don't realize we don't do it now. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Now listen now. Why? Why should I worry about anything? Psalm 103 and 3, who forgiveth all thy iniquities? Who healeth all thy diseases? You're protected when you're sick. You're protected when whatever, when you done blew it, you can go to him like a little child and confess it. Look at the fourth verse. Who redeemeth thy life from destruction. Until you came to the Lord, you were a dead man or a dead woman or a dead child walking. See, destruction is Satan. You want to know why his method of operation? He kills, he steals, and he destroys.
Yes.
So God said, I've done delivered you from all that mess.
Yes.
Why are you saying that? Who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercy. Does that sound like God beating up on somebody?
Yes.
But the world will tell you, man, can't do nothing, boy. You get beat up on. If you do this, and you got to do this, that, and that. No. God told you right there. He crowns you with loving kindness.
Yes.
And tender mercy. Does that sound like somebody want to be? You his child. Do you? I'm talking about folks with good common sense. That's what you try to do for your children. You cover them with loving kindness and tender mercy. Not only that. So my mouth does speak right. What does he do on the fifth verse? Who satisfy thy mouth with good things. So that thy youth is renewed like an eagle. Have mercy. I'm so glad that's there. Amen. Let's go to, we're going to close with Psalm 119. And, you know, I'm going to go straight through from 57 with the hopes that I can go real hurriedly through, but through, I'm going to go, but I want you to read through 77 in order to get, I may not get all of them today. I'm going to go as far as the Lord will tell. See, once you realize and you have confirmed in your own heart, see, when you get to that point, when you say, my heart is fixed, my mind may, I don't care what anybody say. I'm not trying to please you and try to be the hipster. I'm trying to please God. Why do I want to do that? When my ways please the Lord, he said he'd make even my enemies at peace with me. I think I'd rather have that. Wouldn't have to fight so many battles. In other words, what he's saying, you, myself, and all of us, got to be in a position. This is what made David a man after God's own heart. Look what he said in Psalm 119, which we need to say too. And if you wonder what that's the alphabet there, check. Okay, one of 22. Here's what we have to say from our heart. Thou art my portion, O Lord. I have said that I would keep thy word. You got to do a little more than say it. You got to do it. Well, what do you mean? You said he's going to keep, well, a whole lot of things we say we're going to do and don't end up doing. The Bible said, be more than just a hearer of the word. Didn't it say that? Be a doer also. Now, listen now. How many of you don't realize you can do this? He said, I don't care what I'm going through. Look what he said. Very personally, I entreat thy favor. How is he going to do it? Is he going to play with God? With my whole heart. Be merciful unto me according to thy word. See, a lot of times we beat up on ourselves thinking God's going to do it because he don't know the word. Why is that important? Because we do this. He says, I thought on my way. See, sometimes you just have to flat do it for yourself. And turn my feet unto thy testimony. I can't do that for you. All I can do is tell you right now, you are protected. Look what God just told you today. Seek my favor. You always want to please everybody but me.
Well,
you want to buy this, that, and other because they told you if you dress up and shake like the Beyonce, you get any man you want. Doesn't work that way. I'm going to be Jay-Z. Jay-Z is Jay-Z. You're not. Let's go to 119:60. Listen now. I made haste and delayed not to keep thy commandments. You have to ask yourself, is that your first thought when you have a problem? Do you make haste to the word? Or you make haste to the Bible? Do you make haste to the word? Or some drug? Do you make haste to the word to get some wisdom? Or you going to talk to somebody, your friend, they pull in the blind leading the blind?
No, sir. No, sir, Pastor.
He said, now, I don't care what's going on. What he just said, I made haste. And I delayed not to keep thy commandments. Because I know if I do that, I'm protected. Now listen. Because if I don't, look what the next thing going to happen. The bands of the wicked have robbed me. But we don't believe that. We just think that's what's going on. God telling you the band of the wicked will rob you. How do we know that? Get hooked and you'll find out.
Yes, sir.
Take all your money. You still kill and destroy to get that.
Yes, sir.
I don't think you're going to physically kill somebody, but sometimes that has happened.
Yes, sir.
But you'll cause everybody to not trust you. You'll kill every bit of trust around you.
Mm-hmm.
Some folks ain't going to enable you but so long.
So long.
Lord have mercy. Now listen now. The bands of the wicked had robbed me. But when I woke up, but I have not forgotten thy law. In other words, that word is in you. I can't tell you when, but God will turn. He hit that switch, and you're going to do something, or you ain't going to make it. At midnight, don't think he's talking about, no, I don't care how low you go. You know, sometime at midnight, the world says, boy, I will rise to give thanks unto thee because of thy righteous judgment. In other words, let's deal with that like a Hebraic statement. You remember at midnight, them boys had their prayer service in that jail. You see them, they had a mouth job on you. It doesn't matter when you come to God, I'll shake the jail. But them boys was in kind of bad shape. They in stocks. They hadn't done anything wrong. But at midnight, they had what they had, had one of them good old prayer services, didn't they? So it doesn't matter. The other mouth, the minute you pray to me, the minute you acknowledge I've blown it, the minute you decide that no matter what, even though how much I think I'll be enjoying this, I know in my heart it is not good for me, no, and it's against God's word. When that midnight time comes and you cry to him, you ought to be glad he got righteous judgment. You see, because out there in the world, when you cross a certain line, ain't but one way you can come out of a gang. They say feet first. Listen, 63. Now, young people, please go over this with me. Don't get, and some of us, too. Sometimes there's some folks you need to cut loose. But I can tell you that all I want to, and your mama can, too. But let's see what daddy says. One of his man after his own heart. I am a companion of all them that fear thee. In other words, you need to be around people that's exuding that Shekinah glory, that countenance of God, that don't tell me you can't see it, because you can. But the enemy was, man, you can't hang around them, you ain't got nothing. You know, come on over here, man, I got me some, you know, whatever. Some liquid gold, they got all kind of names for it, you know what I mean? I ain't gonna get into all that. But that's not gonna get it done. It's only temporary. You need to be companion of people that fear God so you can get something up in your head, meaning the word of God. And of them that keep thy precepts. They're living their life as the best they can by the word of God. And you can't tell me you ain't been in here long enough to see the difference. Folks who live for God, I don't care what you say. If you're a child of God, you have better intimacy. You have a better life. You have a better everything. But you got to see it for yourself. When you go to college, you're the best student in the class. Why is that? Because God told you in Psalm 119, if you read 9 and 99 wouldn't get in trouble and wouldn't fail nothing. Amen. But you got to get that up here. Listen now. Now listen at this. The 64 verse. The earth, O Lord, is full of thy mercy. But see, they done told y'all in the world that God beat up on him. He's somebody up in heaven with a great big 2x a railroad tie with a spike in it, gonna hit you upside the head every time you have some fun. That's not what that said, is it? It said, the earth, O Lord, is full of thy mercy. We're not talking about the cosmos. We're talking about God's erect, his earth. Why is that important? Because if you understand that it doesn't matter if you're in Istanbul, up in Alaska, down to the South Pole, doesn't matter. You can still say this. Teach me thy statutes. Did it say I had to be there before you could ask? Did it say they have to be there? The deacon asked anybody? You can just say to God, teach me your statutes. And he'll do it. He'll get the knowledge you need. looking at me strange. Now here's the thing I love about this verse. I am so glad God got this in here. Because I know if I'm walking with him and I understand that I'm protected, he's not going to mistreat me.
Well,
I'm going to say it again. God won't mistreat you. But let him tell you right here. It says, thou hast dealt well with thy servant. Now, if you're a servant, he's going to always deal well with you. Because what? He take care of his own. Almost through y'all. Can go, oh Lord, listen at that. Oh Father, according unto thy word. In other words, God is going to deal with you, not with what nobody said or might said, you know, I'm going to lie on you and folks did. No, no. He's going to deal with you according to his word. Have you read it? Do you know it? Then you don't have no problem. Let's go. Look at that. And see, when you ask him to teach you the word, then the next thing you can do is ask him to do this. Because you're protected. It says, teach me good judgment. Oh, how much do we need that? How many things we would not be going through now? Just ask God to teach you good judgment. And then he puts it into, and knowledge. For I have believed thy commandments. Who had to do it? I have to. You have to. See, a lot of times we think because we out there having big fun. A little something hit you upside the head, you think that's God beating up on. No. Sometimes God says, you my elect. And I got to get your attention since you won't listen. But look what happened. Before I was what? Afflicted, I went astray. I got so Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized, I thought I could just do anything. But after that affliction, God got your attention. I don't know which way he might do it. But now, I have what? Kept thy word. Now let's get this straight, plain and simple. You got to know this. It says, thou art good. Everything, God is good.
Yes.
He has nothing to do with bad. We bring bad upon us by our own decisions and what we want to do versus what God has ordained for our life. I can't predict the future, but I know good and well I wouldn't probably be on this chain if I'd have went on and listened to God a long time ago, because I believe he knocked on my heart to preach a long time ago, but I wanted to play football. I wanted to be in a certain part of the armed services. I can't go much farther than that. But that's what I'm saying. I made those decisions. But God is good. God didn't blow my knees up. See what I'm saying? And whatever we go through, don't blame God. And to make it plain, what else? And do is good. Everything he does is good. You got to know that he do is good. Don't be talking about God. Well, why? No. Decision.
Amen.
But now, listen at this. Now, look at this. But looking at this, thou art good and do is good. Now, what? The only thing I need you to do to help me understand is what? Teach me thy statute. Because I know I'm protected. So it's got to be the fact that I done overlooked something. I don't know why we don't think we don't make mistakes. We do it every day, don't we? Some of us have paid 20 times more interest on something because you didn't read the fine print.
Yes, sir.
Don't get quiet on me, y'all. Like, you understand in the natural.
Yes,
God, God have mercy. I'm about through now. 69. The proud have forgotten a lie against me. That forged a lie against me. Excuse me, y'all. I'm getting old. Can't see like I used to. So don't think it's strange when folks lie on you. And you get all upset. And then they win. But when you stay calm, don't have to respond to it. I told you, if I had done half of the stuff folks said, I was going, boy, I had it going on. I'm a pimp. I sold dope. I ain't no way. I could go on and add a list on me like I don't know what. But that's their problem. It's not mine. I wouldn't give them 5 seconds. You go on, think whatever you want to, because I know. But I will. Understand, you have to make this decision. How can I make it? Because I know I'm protected. But I will keep thy precepts with my whole heart.
Yes, sir.
Just that simple. Because as long as I do that, Lord have mercy. I'm almost there, y'all. I'm going to try to finish this, then we're going home. Listen at this. Their heart is as fat as grease, but I delight in the law. In other words, stuff looks good. See what I'm saying? Fat as grease, that's why them Big Macs out there. Come on now. All that fattening food, everything that God don't want you to eat is pushed harder than anything. I'm serious. Folks will run over you to get some coke, and God said you ain't supposed to eat that stuff. Don't have no scales on it. But they still do it. Now, folks, you know, all the stuff that they tell you not to eat, get hammered on television. But that's your choice. Didn't say you were going to go to hell because of that, but you know what fat and grease do to your arteries, don't you? All right. But he said, but I delight in thy law. What does that mean? But I delight in thy law. I would rather go to Leviticus 11 and see what God said I should eat and what I should not eat.
Yes,
see how simple. But what he said, but I delight. In other words, I know that look good. But I'd rather delight and go do what God said, because he said I'm supposed to eat this. I'm not supposed to eat that. He said, I don't want to eat no coons and nothing like that. No. None of them folks that scavenger, leave that pig alone. Because you eat that swine, it's like eating smoke. See what I'm saying? But now if we decide to go on and eat it, and we have high blood pressure, we have cholesterol, and we have all that. No, then you blaming God for that. Who did it? Because I gave you the word to show you that I will protect you if you do what I tell you. The rule is do not eat scavengers. I put them on the earth to take the poison from you, and then you turn around and eat it. And sometimes when we get so hard-headed, just won't hear. Look what God said. You have to come to this point. He said, it is good for me that I have been afflicted. Why? That I might learn thy statutes. I wish it wouldn't be that way, but unfortunately it is. Because some of us go, nah, I'm going to do my thing. Well, God said, go ahead. I mean, all I want you to do is see what you're protected. But now, just like anything else, you said, this is what you said in 72, the law of thy mouth is better unto me than 10,000s of gold and silver. Than thousands of gold and silver. Is his word that valuable to you? If you begin to understand that, then like he said, over here we just read, more because I have set my afflictions unto the house of God, I have my own proper good of gold and silver. It's yours. I mean, I'm going to take care of you. And I can give you as much as you can take care of. I'm not going to give you something because you ain't got sense enough to take care of. soon as I give it to you, and then you end up getting beaten out of it, and then the devil uses it to upgrade his kingdom.
Amen, Pastor.
Amen. See, you have to, look what he said. Why would he protect us, church? Let's get another book on there. I'm about through here. I'm trying anyway. Thy hands, 73, thy hands have made me and fashioned me. What else did he do? Give me understanding that I might learn thy commandments. He made you. Why would he beat up on you? When he took you from the womb, I made you. You see what I'm saying? For some reason, we don't get that. Well, if God made me, why didn't he give me some 48 breasts or something? Or something like that? Okay. Thank God he made you. He said, no matter what you look like, you're fearfully and wonderfully made. You are the apple of my eye. That allows you, better not mess with you. You don't want nobody poking anything in your eye, do you? I'm about through, y'all. I'm trying to quit. Let's finish this thing on off, and we can get ready to go home. 74. They that fear thee will be glad when they see me. Isn't that awesome? Shouldn't be no bickering here in the church. Y'all know how y'all when you see somebody, and bang, you're going on in church. But look what it says. They that fear thee will be glad when they see me. Put yourself in that. You don't get upset with nobody. Because you know what? God took you right where you were. He took you warts and all. Now all of a sudden you done got high and mighty.
Yes, sir.
Anytime you see your sisters and brothers in the church, I'm sorry. Hey, you ought to be glad when you see them. I know we mean well, child. I'm glad to come back to church. No, doesn't matter. Just be glad they're here today. Because the minute you try to correct them, the enemy says, I told you when you come back, they're going to try to put you down. Oh, that man went straight over the head. Just be glad to see him today. Help me, somebody.
It had not.